Shalom, it's Stila from the Kfar. Welcome back or welcome to my channel. This is the place to be to learn Hebrew online, and you can visit thekfar.com to learn more. So this is lesson number 4 in the Learn Hebrew Roots series. You can check out the playlist that I have listed in the video description to see the roots that we have covered so far. So in this lesson, our shoresh is asa, ayin, sin, hey. And words that are derived from this root are related to doing or making. And so when hey is the final letter of a root, like we see here in asa, it may not always appear in words alongside the ayin and the sin. And so it's considered a weak root letter, and it often drops out of verb infinitives or other words. So while you might see ayin, sin, or hey in words that have this shoresh, you'll often just see the first two root letters, the ayin and the sin. So let's look at some examples. Here we have the pa'al verb la'asot, which means to do or to make. And then we have the nif'al verb lehe'asot, which is to be done or to be made. So the active pa'al verb la'asot would be used to say, for example, I did something. And then the passive nif'al verb lehe'asot would be something was done. Okay? So we also have the noun ma'aseh, which is an action or a deed. And the plural is ma'asim, so good deeds would be ma'asim tovim. Another noun derived from this root asa is ta'asiya, which means industry. And for adjectives, we have asui, which means made or done, and it's often used with the preposition me to say that something is made of wood or metal, for example. And another adjective is ma'asi, which means practical. Okay, and note that in many of these examples, we just see the ayin and the sin, like I explained earlier, the first two letters of the asa root. So we see it in la'asot and leheasot, as well as in asui, ayin and sin, and ma'asi, here's our ayin and sin. In many cases, we're not going to see the hey, it drops out as a weak root letter. And again, like I've said in previous videos, these are just a handful of words with the asa root. As you read and listen, you will come across others. So now let's look at a couple of passages from the Tanakh where we see this shoresh asa, and the Tanakh link is included in the description. So in this verse from Genesis 6, we see the verbs aseh and ta'aseh, both from the pa'al verb la'asot, again meaning to do or to make. Aseh is the masculine singular imperative or command form, meaning make. And ta'aseh is the second person masculine singular future tense, meaning you will make. And in this verse from Exodus 18, we have the noun ma'aseh, meaning action or deed, or here work as a noun, and the verb ya'asun, which is the same as ya'asu, meaning they will do. And this nun suffix is called the paragogic nun, if you want to look it up. It doesn't change the meaning or the conjugation of the verb, okay? And as with all the previous roots, this one is highlighted in the fourth story of my Learn Hebrew Through Stories video course. The story is called Ma'ata Oseh, meaning what are you doing? And a new story is released every 14 days to give you plenty of time to go through the activities and really acquire the vocabulary before you move on. And something new that's just been added is after every 4 stories, there is a review. So you can go through the vocabulary again and listen to different sentences. And again, just make sure that you've really acquired it before you've moved on. Okay, and so the link for that is below and also in the video description. So that is all for this lesson, Hebrew Roots Lesson 4. Toda Latzfiyah. Thank you for watching. Let me know your thoughts or questions in the comments and give this video a like if you liked it. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Check out these featured videos below and go to thekfar.com if you want to learn more about the Kfar or learning Hebrew online. Azeu, until next time. Lehitraot.